In this video, I'm going to show you how to simplify an expression like this with a rational exponent by converting it into a radical. First up, the rational exponent. That's the fraction right here, the 5/3. 5/3 has two parts, the numerator and the denominator, and each one means something differently mathematically. First up, the bottom. The denominator is going to tell us what kind of root we have. What kind of radical, the index for our radical. Since this is a 3, it means we're ultimately dealing with a cube root. For example, if it had been a 2, that would be a square root. Now the 5, the top number in our fraction, is more traditionally how we think of an exponent. It's the power we're going to raise this to. Raising it to the 5th power means multiplying it 5 times. Like I said, more consistent with what you think of for exponents. One last bit with this. This fraction 5/3 can be thought of as the number 5 times the fraction 1/3. And that's just because of the rules of multiplying fractions. Realize you just as easily could have switched these two and instead written it as 1/3 times the number 5. Both are equivalent, which means you can order your final answer in two different ways. For convenience, for us to have this work out the way we want, though, we're going to go ahead and use this top one, 5 times 1/3. What this means, if I move my screen up a little bit to have more room, is that we're going to take our original radical and rewrite it, breaking the fraction up like that. So I have my original problem, 3x to the 5/3, and I'm going to think of it as 3x first to the 5 times 1/3. That's just breaking my fraction up into two factors instead of one fraction. Now, because of the rules of exponents, I can realize and rewrite this as the amount 3x, that whole quantity to the 5th power, now this entire amount raised to the 1/3. And this is because of the rules of exponents. When we have an exponent raised to another exponent, like we have here, you go ahead and multiply the exponents. So really all I'm doing is applying that rule in reverse. So looking at this and realizing that this 1/3 as an exponent, as we said before, is really a cube root, we can rewrite this in its radical form, making it easier for us to simplify. So instead of having it with an exponent 1/3, we're going to write it underneath a cube root radical. So I still have my quantity 3x to the 5th. But instead of raising it to the 1/3 power, I'm instead going to write it under this radical, the 3rd root. That's what the 1/3 represents. Now it's just a matter of putting this into simple radical form, meaning simplifying it as much as possible. So we're going to take our radical here, again moving it over so I have some more room, and first look at this part. By the rules of exponents, 3x to the 5th, that whole amount in parentheses, is going to be 3 to the 5th times x to the 5th. Now since this is a cube root and I want to simplify it, meaning take the cube root of whatever part I can take a perfect cube of, meaning it just works out perfectly for me, I want to rewrite things with 3 as an exponent because the cube root of something cubed simplifies very nicely. So 3 to the 5th is 5 3's multiplied together. So I can think of that instead of 5 of them together in one little statement, I can think of that as 3 of them multiplied together, 3 cubed, times another 2 of them left over. 3 cubed times 3 squared is going to multiply together to give me 3 to the 5th. Same thing works for x. Instead of 5 x's together in one little statement, in one expression there, I'm going to think of it as 3 x's multiplied together, and then another two x's multiplied together. So x cubed times x squared, giving me a total of five x's multiplied together. This is the amount that I have inside my cube root. And the reason we wrote it like this is because each of these parts that has 3 as an exponent, this 3 cubed right here, and this x cubed right there, will simplify very nicely. The way it works here, the cube root of 3 cubed will simplify to 3. So basically, I can just pull that 3 outside of the radical. The cube root of x cubed will simplify to x. So again, I can basically just pull that x outside of the radical. The other two parts, 3 squared and x squared, since I cannot take the cube root of them, I have to just leave that part inside the radical to leave this as precise as possible. So taking out the two parts that I know I can, I end up with 3, which is, again, the cube root of 3 cubed, times x, which comes from the cube root of x cubed. And I'm left with the cube root of 3 squared times x squared. Last step, just to get this in its nicest form, simplify what I can here. 3 squared is going to be 9, so I'll just rewrite that, giving me a final answer of 3x times the cube root of 9x squared. And that is my final answer. Taking the original rational exponent, rewriting it as a radical, here a cube root, and then simplifying that radical into simple radical form.